We all want to have our privacy, we want to keep our secrets hidden in a locker, or sometimes we want to prevent our kids or unknown people from opening applications, your WhatsApp, Facebook accounts, or buying apps on Play Store or making transactions without your permissions. And HexLock is a single solution for that. Hi there guys, I'm Nikhil from GreedyTech, and this is a review of HexLock. There are a lot of app locks and apps that can hide your information, but this app does both. For starters, as the name suggests, it's a lock that you can use to lock applications. When you first open it, you'll be asked to set a password or a pattern. Once you set a password, it'll take you to the homepage. If your phone is running Android 6.0 or above, you'll be asked to give the usage access permission. Just select HexLock and enable the toggle and go back. Now we have profiles, one for office, and if you slide left, we have the profile for home. And if you're not satisfied with the existing list of profiles and want more, you can add a new profile by clicking the plus button and selecting the profile template. You can rename the profile name and change profile icons too. For a specific profile like office, we can select the apps that we want to lock, and every time you open those apps, you will be asked to enter a password or a pattern. We can use a fingerprint scanner to unlock the apps if your device has fingerprint scanner and is running Android Marshmallow and above. You need to enable an option in the settings if you want to use your fingerprint. Switching between profiles is very easy, just swipe and select a profile to activate it. Now you have locked an app and enabled a profile. Whenever you open a locked application, you will see this screen. You can either enter the password or use a fingerprint to move forward. We have the option to customize the lock screen, we can change colors or use images from gallery. Normally I wouldn't go through all that trouble, I'll just leave it to that. We do see some ads on lock screen, which is definitely annoying, but you can get the paid version to remove them. Most of the time lock screen works perfectly, but sometimes it's a second slow, so you might end up having a glance at the locked app. Well, we all like to lock apps, but we don't want to do that all the time. So you can disable the lock altogether by selecting the off profile. If you're lazy like me, you can configure the app to automatically switch between profiles based on your Wi-Fi connection like this. We can do this to all our profiles, and I do it most of the time. Next, if we go to settings, we have Uninstall Protection, which basically blocks you or the intruder from uninstalling the application. So let's say your colleague took your phone and he tries to access your Facebook or WhatsApp account, it's locked. Then he might try to uninstall the lock application itself. And this basically prevents that, so you should definitely enable this option. Let's say you opened an app and then went to home screen and then came back. Now you'll be asked to enter the password again, and this happens every time. If you want to change this behavior, you can change this option from immediate to 10 seconds or 20 seconds, and you won't be bothered for 10 seconds or 20 seconds if you're switching between applications. Now these are all the features that you can tinker around with app lock, but if you slide from left, you have the media vault where you can hide your files, basically videos and images. Just click the plus button and select the media you want to add to the vault. As of now, this is all we can do. We can only hide images and videos. I wish we could add them to a separate folders and then export those folders to a specific location. I hope they add that feature too. As of now, this app works well without any flaws. It has all the basic features everyone needs, but lacks some advanced customization options like I said before. So that's all for this video guys. Check out these suggested videos, and if you have any feedback or want us to make any specific video, let us know by commenting below this video and subscribe to us to see more cool videos like this. I'm Nikhil from GreedyTech signing off. I'll talk to you in my next video.